Hey everybody, what's up? It has been a loving me weekend, and I am so excited to put this video up. So before I get into that, I want to talk about what's good in our world. This past weekend, I had the chance to volunteer for something that isn't mine, something that serves people who are HIV positive or battling AIDS, but it wasn't Do Something Saturday or Unplugging HIV. On Saturday, I had the opportunity to volunteer for the closing ceremonies of AIDS Life Cycle 10. And you guys remember I actually trained for AIDS Life Cycle 8 and just had so many things going on. And the first impression that I got from the people running AIDS Life Cycle 8 here in Los Angeles was a very, very negative one. But recently I met someone named Allison, who is the volunteer coordinator for AIDS Life Cycle 10, and I met her as I was getting all the resources put together for the HIV resource board for my outreach down on Skid Row. And I had the chance to speak with her, and almost immediately when I walked in and started speaking to her, I felt like this vibe, this energy, almost like light seeing light. And it just felt right. So in speaking with her, I was like, hey, I want to get involved in this. So this past Saturday, I got to do that. Now, I asked a bunch of people. I think it was like 60 people total. A bunch of people said yes. But of the 60, I think it dwindled down to like 16 people that actually showed up. I didn't actually get to volunteer because we all showed up at different times. So I didn't get to volunteer with the group of people that did come out, and the person that was supposed to go with me the day of ended up throwing a tantrum, and I'm glad they threw a tantrum because you remember my video, don't be held hostage. I'm not going to be held hostage to any person, place, or thing, and this includes people who I consider friends. So this past weekend, as a result of something that happened on Thursday, which nearly destroyed my Canon Rebel, and then their subsequent behavior on Saturday prior to leaving to volunteer has led me to remove them from my life until they get help for their alcoholism and their clear pattern that is destructive. And that's all I'm going to say on that. So I left here and I headed out, and the first thing I saw when I got on the grounds of the Veterans Administration was the AIDS Memorial Quilt. I have never seen the AIDS Memorial Quilt in person. I've seen pictures of it, and it's just so different when it is in front of you. So many emotions. My tears started flowing. So much I was thinking about. You guys can, I blogged it all out, so you guys can check that out. And then I was assigned to gear, and gear is the unloading of the trucks, of all the gear that the riders have. And these riders ride 545 miles from San Francisco to Los Angeles to raise money for people battling HIV or AIDS, either in San Francisco or here in Los Angeles, through the organizations of the AIDS Foundation in San Francisco and the Gay and Lesbian Center here in Los Angeles. Now, while this funding won't affect me directly because I don't get services from either organization, it felt really, really good to be a part of it. And the people that I met, the experiences that I had from that day are really, really positive. But the What's Good in Our World first is Allison for one, reminding me about the event and being such a positive energy, such a light. And I was just like, wow, what is that all about? Because that's not what I experienced before. So I wanted to see what it was all about, and it was well worth it. But also to say thank you to all the writers. All the writers who raised however much money you raised combined for people battling HIV or AIDS in Los Angeles or San Francisco. 545 miles for someone you don't know, for someone you may never meet. Let me say, for me, thank you for thinking of someone like me, someone battling HIV or AIDS. I think what's important for people to remember is sometimes we look at the AIDS quilt and we remember the lives lost. There are over 1 million+ people here in the United States, bit my tongue, in the United States battling HIV or AIDS. So for someone to get on a bike and ride 545 miles, that represents what's good in our world. So my hat is off to you. I thank you. I am humbled by you doing what you did. So let's talk about my 9365 Loving Me weekend. Okay, so like I said, my weekend was just incredible, and it was filled with so much energy and so much connection and so much peace and calmness and joy. And I am moving into the very busy week of outreaches and peer support and planning that I have for the organization, as well as things that I need to get accomplished for myself personally. Just a very, very busy week. So I am energized by the weekend that I have had. And it actually starts Thursday night. Thursday night, I went to the downtown LA Art Walk. And that's where my camera was nearly destroyed. And besides that, there was just this electric energy in the air. I was born and raised here, so downtown LA has never been a destination spot. And now there's like all these new things springing up in downtown Los Angeles. LA Live, the Staples Center, the LA Art Walk, the downtown LA Art Walk. There's so much going on down there. The Truck It Fest, so much going on in downtown Los Angeles. So this was my first time going. And again, I blogged this all out as well. The blog doesn't have any pictures, sorry. But I did blog it all out. Just the energy, the feel of the crowd. It was jam-packed, so if you live in Los Angeles and you haven't taken the chance to take this in, you definitely need to take this in. I ended that night in what I call Food Truck Alley, and it is just a parking lot where there are all these food trucks and tables like all the way around, well, just scattered about. And then in the very, very back in the corner was this band cutting it up, live band just cutting it up. And I had that's how I closed out my night. Walked back to the train, met up with friends on the train who tried to repair my camera, did a pretty good job. Thank you very much, Mason. I really appreciate your hard work. Thanks, Jennifer, for letting Mason stay here all night to try to salvage my camera. Friday was another busy day for me, but Friday night was jazz. So I was hanging out with Franklin, and I met a new friend, Brian, there. And the jazz was just so amazing, and it was really, really special to me because this particular group that was playing was a favorite of my mother and father's. So I was so energized to see that. I got to shake his hand, and he's like, oh, I remember your father, your father. And I was like, oh my God, yeah, yeah, yeah. So it was just amazing to be a part of that. Again, some pretty awesome pictures, and I blogged out my experience. Actually, I haven't blogged that out, so I still need to blog that out. Then Saturday, I got up to volunteer for the AIDS Life Cycle, and like I said in the first segment of this video, it was just an amazing experience to hear people share their stories of what it meant and why they would do something like that was just amazing. And to just see people embrace each other and hug each other and thank each other. And every time I snapped a picture, I was like, thank you. To shake somebody's hand and say thank you was just so very, very moving. So Allison, thank you very much for encouraging me to be a part of that. It was kind of cool because I bumped into some friends that I had known since I lived in San Francisco, and even though we still keep in contact, we don't get to see each other. So it was kind of cool to bump into them at closing ceremonies. Then today was Los Angeles's Gay Pride in West Hollywood, and Franklin, me, and Dodger went and met up with my friends Andy and Tina, and it was just an amazing day. And it was just a spectacular day. The energy was good, the vibe was good, and it was very, very personal for me. And I left that event on such a high, such a good energy, and such a good vibe. It's just been an incredible weekend, and it's been a 90/365 loving me weekend. I think Darlena, Black Butterfly, and myself are the only ones doing the 90/365 journey, but it was an amazing time for me. I got to speak with Darlena, I think on Saturday, spoke with her briefly, and then chatted with her Saturday night. I'm always talking to Laura, Black Butterfly, so it's been cool to have them transition with me into this new Loving Me journey, the 90/365 journey. It is so much fun, and I apologize that I haven't been doing update videos. And letting my hair grow, as you can see. Letting the beard grow in, and I'm liking it. I'm loving it. I like the gray hair. My grandpa used to say gray hair is wisdom. So I am sucking up all the wisdom and embracing all the wisdom that God sees fit to bestow upon me. I have a busy week, big announcement. Let's talk about the blog and the website first. The blog and the website have a new design, new layout, and I'm so excited about it. You can see my tweets there, my Flickr photos, my YouTube channel, the Do Something Saturday page on Facebook. If you guys haven't liked that page, could you please go and like it and participate? So many of you guys send me messages, oh, we can't friend you here, we can't friend you here. You can go and like the page and see all the things that are Do Something Saturday Unplugging HIV. Check it out! Anyway, so DoSomethingSaturday.com, DoSomethingSaturday.org, they are both mine, so check out the new website, let me know what you think. And lastly, I was invited to photograph and blog about an event next Sunday for Children's Hospital, Los Angeles. Really excited about that, so I gotta get my camera fixed. The cool thing is that the love of my life, for 15 years, someone whom I am still very, very close to, we communicate every single day, we're the very best of friends, told me, he's like, you know what, if we can't get it fixed, you just get another camera. So hopefully tomorrow, Sammy's camera will be able to repair my camera and make it work properly. Peace and blessings, everybody. I hope you are well. Have a great week, and we'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye.